Hello, welcome to this video in which I'm going to be going through Nornir, which is the Python automation framework. Hello, my name is Roger Perkin. I am a network engineer. I'm based in the UK. And if you're watching this on YouTube, there's a link below the video which will point you to this blog post on my website, which I'm referencing. And if you're watching the video within that blog post, then you're here already. So let's get started. If you don't know what Nornir is, it's a Python automation framework which has been written by David Barroso, which was written to address some of the issues with the other automation tools that are around at the moment, mainly Ansible, which whilst it's a great tool, had a few flaws that needed to be addressed, and the main one was speed and flexibility. So Nornir has been built purely on a Python, and it's written in Python, and you write all your tasks in Python. It runs very fast, and if you can do something in Python, then you can do it within Nornir. So it gives you a great deal of flexibility. You do need to have some Python knowledge to run it, so we'll be going through a bit of that now. So before we go any further, we need to install Nornir. So the first thing to do is literally to run this command, which is pip3 install Nornir. And I've got my Ubuntu machine here, which I'm going to run pip3 install Nornir on. Now this will go off and pull all the requirements down to get Nornir. While that's installing, we'll go back to the post here, and we should be installing at this time of recording, which is March the 13th, 2020. Nornir 2.4.0, that's what we're hoping is going to come down. And then once we've installed it, we need to create a few files. Now these are YAML files. It's the only YAML that you'll need to do just to get Nornir up and running. And then once we've got it working, everything else is written within Python itself. So we will need a defaults file. This defines any values that are relevant to your devices. From a top level, and there's a hierarchy to this. Then we get into groups, where you can specify values that relate to groups of devices. And then the hosts are the actual devices themselves. And then the config.yml file, which we need to create, just basically tells Nornir where all these other files are. So if we pop back into the installation. So we are there now. So let's just see what we've got. Now for my environment, I'm just installing this straight into my machine. You could use a Python virtual environment to install it depending on your requirements, but for now I'm just going to go through this so you can see how it operates. So there we've got Nornir 2.4.0. that's perfect, and we need to start creating some files. So within my machine I've got a Nornir directory which I've created, and within that Nornir directory I'm going to create an inventory folder where we're going to put all the inventory files. So let's step back to the blog post, see what I need to create first. So we need to start with a config.yaml. This file contains all the information about where the other three files are, and we've got a file called config.yaml, and that goes in the root of the Nornir folder. So let's just take all of that, and in the Nornir root, this is going to be called config.yaml. We're going to pop that in there. Now I'll step you through what each line does. So the num workers, this tells Nornir how many devices to go out and connect to at the same time. So this is one of the big benefits of Nornir, in that it can go out to many, many devices all at the same time, run what it needs to and pull the data back. So we've got it set for 100 at the moment, which is more than adequate. Then we run this simple inventory plugin, which is just part of the Nornir infrastructure, and that allows us to then specify these device options here, and this is literally telling Nornir where we've got all the other bits. So we've got the inventory slash hosts.yml, groups.yml, and the defaults.yml. Now, the location of these files will be different to your environment. But for me, let's just see where I am. I'm going to be like this. So I just need to take my file structure. So this will be obviously different for you within your environment. So this is where my files are. So we've created now the config.yaml file. We now need to go and create these three files, the hosts, the groups, and the defaults. So in the order that I've got it specified here, we're going to create the host file. Now the host file looks like this, so I'll copy that in, and then we'll talk through what it's all about. So within the inventory folder here, I'm going to do a hosts.yaml. So I've got actually in my environment five routers. So I'm going to copy these out a bit more so we can see. And all we do is define the name that you want the device to look like within Nornir when you run the tasks. And then the host name is the either the fully qualified domain name or the IP address. Now, there are many, many extra attributes that you can put into the host file, which are detailed very well in the documentation. But the two that you absolutely have to have in place for this to work are the host name and the groups. So for CSR1, the host name is, this is the IP that it's going to connect on, and I've put it in the group CSR routers. And then we've got CSR2, and I've also got three more. This one's going to be called CSR3, and that one's 222, CSR4. And I've got these are CSR routers which are running on EVENG on a ESXi host I've got elsewhere. So we'll connect to those shortly. So this has now defined my hosts. And that one is 224. So five routers, they are all in the group CSR routers. So let's go back to the post. What is it saying now? So the next file is the groups.yaml, and that's one you can actually specify any data that is relevant to that group. So we'll just copy that. So within the inventory folder again, we need another file, which is groups.yaml. So this one, very simply, I've just specified some data and I've put in one NTP server of 1.1.1. You can do anything you like in here, whatever you like, but I've just put this in for reference. So we've got the file in place. And then the most important one is the defaults. And this defines all the default values that apply to everything underneath it. So Nornir runs on a very hierarchical structure. So anything defined here will ripple down to every device, but you can then override that structure further down the tree. So the last file was defaults.yaml. We'll put that in here. So I've just got three defaults. You have to define the platform of the device, and in this case we're running iOS, and the username for these devices is Roger, the password is Cisco. So that's the three files: defaults, groups, and hosts. And then we've got our config file in place, so that's all looking good. And then what I've got here then is five CSR routers, which I'll show you in a minute. And the last thing is to actually write the Python script that we're going to run to connect to all the devices. So this is the Python script here, and I've called mine start.py. So that's going to be created in here. So this one is called start.py. And we'll pop that code in there. So if we talk through this, what we're going to do is import from Nornir the init Nornir element. This then specifies where the config file is, which is this config file here. And then from Nornir, we're going to import a couple of the bits, which is the netmiko send command. This is going to allow us to run the send command from within netmiko. And then we're going to import the print result, which will allow us to print to the screen. And then we're going to run this command. So this is netmiko send command. And the string that we're going to run is shyp interface brief. So what this script here will do is connect to every device, my five routers. I'll just bring them up here. So I've got five CSR routers running on EVENG. And I'll just show you the IP of this one. So this is 192.168.1.220. And that one's 221, etc., etc. So it's going to connect to those five devices and run the command show IP interface brief. So if everything's in place, we should be able to now start Python. Nope, we're not going to do that. I'm actually going to run it straight from here. Python 3 start.py. So this is going to fail. Of course it is. Okay. Okay, so we've hit an error. And the great thing about this is it tells you exactly where the problem is. So it's telling me that I've got a problem on my host file in line 3, column 1. So this is a YAML formatting error. And I imagine when I did the copy paste that the formatting has not worked exactly. And you can see this value here, CSR1, is out of line with this one here. So if we just bring all of these in line. So that's the problem with YAML, is that it's very picky about the spacing. Now I will put all this code on my GitHub so you can just pull it straight down without any of these problems. So that should fix that. So now this is going to go off, hit all five devices at once and run that command show IP interface brief. Bang, there we go. And print it to the screen. So that's the information, and you can see how quick it is. It's once it's processed the commands, it comes out and takes it. So I hope this video has been informative for you, and this is actually the beginnings of a course I'm putting together on netmiko. So this is learning a course I'm putting together on Nornir, which the details of that will be listed below the video, and there's also a link on the website. So I hope you've enjoyed this, and please stay tuned for more videos, and I hope that this has given you an insight into how to start using Nornir and how to install it and how to just get up and running, and then we'll go into some more advanced videos at a later date. So thank you, and I'll see you in the next video.